Today, we're discussing good manufacturing practices, or GMPs for short. GMPs are the things we do to make sure we don't contaminate the food or products we make for our customers. A lot of what we will talk about are simple, common sense behaviors and practices. These practices are what you, as a food manufacturing associate, must do to make a safe product. The goal of GMPs is pretty simple. Keep anything that's not on your label out of your product. We're in the business of handling food. The people who buy our products, they're not any different than you or me. Often, they are you and me. They don't want any surprises when they open one of our products. They want to be confident the people who prepared the food they're about to eat took great care in making it. That confidence goes by the wayside when someone finds a hair or a candy wrapper where it shouldn't be. So what do we have here? Eating, drinking, chewing gum, having a candy, or a cough drop? There's a place for all that, the lunchroom. And smoking? That happens outside the building or wherever your designated area is. There are several reasons for keeping everyone's treats, lunch, and beverages away from production lines. We don't want anything foreign to fall in the product by accident. Also, if you're eating in the plant, you don't have an opportunity to wash your hands. That's a problem because your hands have bacteria on them and possibly traces of allergens from your snack. We also want to keep the work areas in the plant clean and free from any bits of food that could attract insects or rodents. Now, what's wrong with this picture? First, you don't have to wait until you see flies buzzing around to think of personal hygiene. There's nothing excessive about a daily wash, a change of clothes, brushing your teeth, and applying some fresh deodorant. It's important to wear clean clothing when handling food because grime or odors on you could be transferred to the food during handling. Nail polish or fake nails aren't allowed because they can chip, flake, or fall off into the product. There shouldn't be anything loose above your waist. Nothing in your shirt pockets, no pens behind your ear. Nothing that can fall on equipment or in the product. That's also true for jewelry. She's wearing all kinds. The only jewelry allowed are a plain wedding band or a Medic Alert bracelet. Everything has a place. The place to store your personal belongings is in your locker. The place for your lunch is in the lunchroom. It's difficult to manage good sanitation if things are left lying around and your fellow employees don't enjoy coming in and cleaning up after you. Never leave small items like pens or pencils, tools, or maintenance items like small bolts, screws, or nails on or above production equipment. They could fall into or be pulled into the equipment. The single most important thing you can do before working with food? Wash your hands. Make sure there is ample soap and paper towel available. You should also wash your hands after eating, after smoking, after blowing your nose, and after using the washroom. Hopefully this is nothing new. Remember, you should also wash your hands after handling anything dirty or when you do work that's very messy. So a rule of thumb, before you handle food, give a quick think to where your hands have been. If you've just taken out the trash or handled your cell phone, swing by a sink before you start working again. Pay attention to your fingernails. They collect dirt underneath. And a further word about cell phones. They're filthy. They go everywhere with people, including the restroom. Everyone washes their hands after using the toilet, but no one washes their cell phone. Cell phones are also a distraction. When people talk on their phone, they lose track of where they are. That's an accident waiting to happen. So the general rule is, anything that can't be cleaned, makes a noise, and can distract you from working safely or doing your job properly should be left in your locker. Keep the doors closed. We want to keep bugs, birds, and strangers outside where they belong. This includes dock doors and man doors. Propping a door open for easy ventilation allows bugs and rodents into the building. Keep socializing to the lunchroom. Don't wander around the plant. You risk putting yourself and the product in danger when you're in an area where you don't understand what's happening around you. If you hurt yourself, report it immediately so you can be taken care of. You won't be allowed to handle any product if you have a significant cut or an open sore. If you have a minor cut, you can wear a Band-Aid over it, but you must also wear a glove to cover that Band-Aid. If you're not feeling well, you're better off at home, not only for the product, but for the rest of the people you work with. Many people take great pride in not missing a day of work. However, coming to work when you're unwell is not a good practice. If you're experiencing cough, fever, vomiting, diarrhea, cold or flu-like symptoms, do everyone a solid. Stay home, take a rest. When you work with food, you often have to wear special protective clothing, like arm covers, a smock, a hairnet, and maybe a beer net if you have a beard. Hair isn't on anyone's menu. A word or two about gloves. Treat gloves like your hands. Wash them as needed. The nice thing about gloves is they can be replaced when they're dirty. Remove your gloves before leaving the production or packing area. Put on a new pair after eating, smoking, or after using the washroom. The thing to remember is, just because your hands are clean doesn't mean your gloves are clean. If they get dirty, change them. If you have reusable gloves, keep them clean and replace them when they start wearing out. Never stand in or on equipment. Don't step on packaging materials like boxes or labels just because they happen to be sitting on a pallet on the floor. We don't want dirt from the floor in the product. You can probably spot right away that he shouldn't be drinking here. But what else is wrong with this picture? It's the glass. Glass fragments are dangerous. We don't want them in the product. They can easily injure people. So to avoid the chance of breaking glass in the plant, avoid bringing any glass in there at all. Not only to drink out of, but any glass tools, parts, or equipment as well. Here's another easy to remember rule of GMP. Nothing on the floor, ever. No exceptions. Raw materials and finished products that hit the floor are waste. They're no longer usable. This is not negotiable. There is no 5-second rule. Trash goes in a trash can. Product waste goes in waste containers. Tooling and machine parts cannot be stored on the floor. Clean them and return them to their proper storage area. Work tools and utensils should never touch the floor. Have toolboxes and hangers available. Wipe tools down before putting them away. Hoses should be hung up after use and not dropped on the floor. They're used for cleaning only. They should never be immersed in vats or tanks. They're not an all-purpose tool for clearing drains. The general rule of thumb here, the floor is a walking surface, not a storage area. Packaging is a raw material and needs to be treated like any other ingredient. Packaging materials must be stored on pallets off the floor. Keep all packaging in the storage area covered to protect it from dirt and dust. Don't walk on packaging. Don't set things on pallets of packaging. Packaging is meant to hold product, nothing else. Not to hold sweepings, not to wrap old parts, not to wedge in the packer to make sure the bags go in the right direction. It doesn't happen very often that a dirty bag gets to a customer, but when it does, it's very embarrassing. If you use chemicals, wear proper PPE. This is to protect your skin, your eyes, and your lungs. Store chemicals away from processing areas. This is to keep them from ending up in the product. If you see someone who looks like they don't belong in your facility, mention it to someone who can do something about it, like your supervisor. Visitors who've signed in will be easy to recognize. They'll be wearing a badge and/or they'll be accompanied by an employee you recognize. Another best practice? Leave maintenance to the maintenance team. However, communication is very important. They can't fix things they don't know about, so let them know. You can also notify your supervisor if you see an issue. If someone from the maintenance team is doing a temporary fix, repairs should only be made with food-grade materials. Those can be cleaned. No duct tape or cardboard. These do not make a cleanable surface, and we don't want them in the product. That's a lot of information, but much of it should feel like common sense. In summary, GMPs are the things you can do as an employee to make sure the products you make are wholesome and edible. So remember, if it's not on the product label, you don't want it in the product. Everything has a place. It's up to you to make sure things are in that place. Hand washing and personal cleanliness are very important. The floor is a walking surface and not a storage place. Treat packaging like an ingredient. And if you're not feeling well, stay at home until you're better. Your actions and habits matter when you work with food. If you can practice all this, you're using the best practices in manufacturing, and you've got a great handle on GMPs.